waiting for? Come on and hurry up, find a seat. Come on, get comfortable. I cannot wait for the special guest to arrive. Do you like surprises? Did you get surprised by maybe a present that you received under the Christmas tree today? Maybe the surprise of a special family member or a friend that you weren't expecting to show up for the holidays and then they did? Oh man, the excitement of waiting for something or someone to arrive is super fun. But sometimes it can take a really long time or feel like a really long time. It makes me think of some people in the Old Testament. People maybe that you've heard of, like Noah, Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, Moses, Isaiah. People of the Old Testament. Okay, so God had made a promise to them and they were waiting anxiously for this promise to arrive. The promise came because way back at the very beginning, when God created everything, when he created the heavens, the earth, the birds, the trees, the ground, the water, the stars, the moon, and then he created two humans. Who were they? Adam and Eve. Ah, and it was beautiful and perfect and peaceful and loving and amazing. And then one day, Adam and Eve chose to disobey God. And because of their disobedience, sin entered the world. Sin, something that we do that goes against what God has planned for us. A disobedience to God. Sin entered the world. And then all of a sudden, things in the world started to shift. Anger and hatred and jealousy and pain and sickness and a lack of hope and a lack of peace just started coming into the world because of their choice. Ah, but our all-knowing God had a plan. This was no surprise to God. He had a plan. And he knew that someday he was going to bring the world a savior. And so for years, God was making promises to important people that we read in the Old Testament. He was making promises that they held on to, that someday this Messiah, this Savior would come into the world to help them to completely change things that they knew of. God sent messages to prophets like Isaiah. We read in Isaiah chapter 9, verse 6, this remember verse, if you know it, say it with me. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders, and he will be called, say it with me, Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, and the Prince of Peace. What an incredible promise. And when God makes a promise, God always keeps his promises, always. Sometimes they don't happen as fast as we would like them to happen. Sometimes we have to wait a really long time, kind of like my guest. Why is this taking so long? Okay, so people of the Old Testament held on to the promise of God that God would someday send a Savior into the world to correct the things that went wrong, to fix the broken, to help heal what sin was doing to the world. They held on to this promise. Okay, so hundreds of years later, God sent an angel into the world to tell a beautiful young lady named Mary that she was specially chosen. Mary, she was called, she was set apart because her life glorified God. She lived her life differently than all the other women in the world because God chose her over all the other women to complete this special task. The angel told Mary that she would become pregnant, but not pregnant like normal humans get pregnant. She would become pregnant by the power of the Holy Spirit. And she would bear a son that came from God, and she's gonna call him Jesus. Well, what incredible news this was to Mary, but she needed something else to take place, and the angel knew it. So God sent an angel to Joseph to make sure that Mary and Joseph were on the same page because they were soon to get married. So God sent the angel to Joseph to tell him the same news. And so then Joseph and Mary, traveled to the little town of Bethlehem because the government had issued a decree that everybody needed to go back to their hometown so that they could take a count of how many people were still in that town. And so people crammed into every nook and cranny they could find in this little town of Bethlehem. It reminds me of a song. Well, this little town of Bethlehem, it was running out of room, and Mary was running out of time because she was pregnant. So Joseph and Mary found one place that they could rest their heads, and it was quite fitting because it was surrounded by God's own creation, animals. And they found their way into a stable. And then an angel and angels filled the sky to talk to plenty of other shepherds who were just casually out in the field taking care of their sheep. God sent an angel to fill the sky to proclaim the good news that something was about to happen. And then, surprise! Happy birthday, Jesus!
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 Our special guest has arrived. Jesus was born. The Savior of the world was born like a cute little tiny baby like you and me. And boy, was it time to celebrate. The promise that people held on to for years was finally coming true. And this is a cause for celebration. And I don't know about you, but most of the birthday parties that I go to usually have a game. So you know what? Because this is a birthday party, it's game time.
It's time to play Spot the Difference Christmas Edition. You are going to be shown two festive holiday scenes. There will be five subtle differences between them. Use your keen eyesight to pick them out. You will have 60 seconds for each scene. Shout at the screen when you notice what is different. Let's see if you are sharp enough to spot the difference. Here we go, round one. It's time for round two. Get all five? Who's ready for round three? you do. Last one, round four. Job. Thanks for playing Spot the Difference. Merry Christmas!
Today we celebrate Jesus. God sent his son Jesus into this world to become the savior of the world, to live a perfect life, to perform miracles, and then to proclaim the good news of his Father to others, to tell everybody about his Heavenly Father, and to tell them about a hope and a future that he has prepared for them, to fix what was broken, to make an easier way for people to have a relationship with the all-powerful, all-knowing, incredible Creator God. He created a way for you and me to have a relationship with Jesus, with our Creator, and I think that is the most perfect gift this world has ever received. It far exceeds anything that could be under that Christmas tree today, for sure. God's gift of Jesus is for you, for me, for our brothers, our sisters, our neighbors, for every single person around the world. And I don't know about you, but this hope and this joy and this love that came into the world with Jesus, and because we get to have a relationship with him, that is good news. Boys and girls, may you know how much God loves you. He loves you so much that he sent his perfect son into the world for you and me. John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his one and only son, that whoever believes in him will not perish, but will have eternal life. And that is a promise we get to celebrate. Will you pray with me today? God, thanks. Thank you for sending your son Jesus into the world. Thanks for loving us. Thanks for giving us a hope, a future. Thanks for having a plan. You are the all-knowing God, and we trust you. God, when things may not make sense, when we may have to wait what seems like forever for a promise to take place, we trust you because, God, you know all, and you have our interests in your mind, and you care about us. We love you, Jesus. Thank you so much for Christmas and for sending Jesus in your name. Amen. Well, guys, I hope you have a super fantastic rest of your day celebrating. Oh, so exciting. And then we cannot wait to celebrate with you next Sunday at 10 a.m. on New Year's Day for a family style service at each of our campuses. It's going to be a great day. Guys, we love you so much. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
So God sends the angel to tell Moses the same. I said Moses. Why do I keep calling him Moses? Hello, I am not Moses. I am Joseph.